I decided to do something a little weird. There are four movies in this series, and I've decided to watch them in the reverse order. I've already seen part three, and now this is the spin-off called Sabrina. I'm deliberately watching these movies out of order to see if they make any sense. By watching these movies out of order, I know that what appears to be a small thing is probably going to end up being the major hook of the series, and I'm fine with that. Headlining this spin-off is a hideously ugly doll, which seems to be quite normal for this series. A family missing a loved one, yet another series trope, and two characters who are suspiciously like Ed and Lorraine Warren from the Conjuring and Annabelle movies. Even if I'm terribly wrong, my gut feeling is this movie series and those two characters in Bularas and her husband Reynard are Indonesian cinema's version of that popular US horror movie series. Vanya is a little girl who recently lost her mother and now lives with her uncle Aiden and his wife Myra, who also lost her daughter, apparently in the previous movie, which like I said, I haven't seen yet. Vanya learns of a game called Charlie Charlie, which uses a yes-no board and a cool little iPad app that seems to be more style than substance. She uses this game to call the spirit of her mother, but another spirit answers her call instead. Using the ugly Sabrina doll as a way to infiltrate the human world, the spirit comes face to face with its nemesis from the previous film in Spirit Hunters Bularas and her husband Reynard, who steal an ancient Javanese sword that's used to protect a small village from spirits to defeat it. So if I'm being brutally honest, I think I'd rather see the movie about the village that they took that sword from and all the chaos that they've unleashed there. But you know what? We're actually talking about Sabrina. And there are a few things I'd like to say about this movie. Firstly, pick a slightly better looking doll. It's really obvious from the start that the doll's going to be used for evil when you see how ugly it is. Good Lord, why is the doll so damn ugly? How is Reynard, the husband, so unkillable? He gets stabbed a few times, including in the shoulder and heart, yet like Lazarus, he's able to rise and run around at the end, doing some very heavy lifting. Obviously, he never misses Guns Day at the gym. On top of that, Bularas also seems to be able to ignore two stab wounds in her upper shoulders that would render any other normal human incapacitated. And speaking of injuries and people being unkillable, why is the body count of this movie a big fat 2? That's it. 2 kills. Boring. Why are the thunderstorms in Indonesia so violent? And why do they always occur on nights when bad things are about to go down? Could any of the events in the film happen during the daytime? And if not, why not? How did the couple manage to get the whole resort to themselves? There doesn't even seem to be any other staff there, and these people don't look like the types who can take care of themselves, other than the fact that Moira makes a pretty awesome looking pancake. But my biggest grievance with the film is trying to work out whose story it's telling. Now I understand that even though this movie is technically a spin-off, it's actually a direct sequel to part 2, which is the reason why halfway through the film we get this switcheroo where we end up following Bularas and her husband instead of the little girl. Then there's a whole bunch of revelations that tie up the loose ends of part 2, and it makes me really wish that I didn't watch these movies in the wrong order. At least I know that in part 3, which is a lot of fun, Bularas and her husband have a very, very minor role. Take that, Ed and Lorraine, Bularas and Reynard. Now this movie could have been so much fun, but in the end we end up with an ugly hook-nosed spirit, and no guess what that's a reference to, and an even uglier doll whose real presence in the movie is kind of unneeded. Now, let's go and watch part 2 and see how much of this review is actually redundant. I'm the Artie Dans. You are watching Shockmania. Thank you for joining me on this review of Sabrina. Press like if you've seen the movie. Subscribe, maybe, if you're interested. Otherwise, catch you next time, where I'm probably going to look at the doll too.